You know what gets me going is the guy who builds 6 or 7, maybe even 8 105s, and you're advancing. You're moving your riflemen up. You got the M8s up as well as the Shermans, and they're moving up, and you're advancing. And here comes that lone shell from that 105. Multiple 105 shells. Here they come, gonna blow up your men. That friendly fire. Isn't that nice to have where your teammate is actually lobbing giant shells at your men? I mean, you're better off giving those guys some baseball mitts to catch those things, because they're making such a big explosion. It's worthless out there. This guy is building enough 105s to pretty much make the map look like the moon, and it really wants to make you slam your forehead right into the counter of your kitchen. Are you kidding me? I almost want to jump in front of oncoming traffic like a semi coming down the road, just jump right into it and say, hey, hit me, because I'd rather take this hit than a freaking 105 shell hit and have my fours. I met a strange lady, she made me nervous. She took me in and gave me breakfast. And she said, do you come from a land down under? Where women go and men plunder? Can't you hear the thunder? You gotta run, you gotta take cover. Hello dudes, Dougster here, giving you another Shoutcast Game 2 Finals. ECRecon in the Far East, going to be playing as Vermont. In the Far West, we've got Tox. Let's get this thing started under the 5-second mark and start it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, unpause. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Hope you got your beer with you and your cider. Tox came out strong last game, pretty much owned up ECRecon, very nice counters, very nice usage of the MGs and the Grenadiers and all that such. A lot of people going to be thinking about doing Shoutcast these days. Tycoon going to be doing one, Order going to be doing one, and so is Everdos going to continue his little series. Might I add, I might make this look so easy that a lot of people want to do it again. So good luck to those guys. There's only one place to find a Dougster cast, and that's at ECZOH.com. Mad props to Everdos for doing these videos. If we go to the tactical map, we've got 3 engineers. I wouldn't be surprised to see a 4th from Tox. He might be going with WSC to follow that one up. An old strategy used back in the old days, the caveman days, before the patches were released. In the Far East, we've got a heavy machine gun coming out from ECRecon. Very choppy this replay, as there's something going on with the code, I believe. I wonder if Everdos is going to be picking that up on the video. Sometimes replays tend to transfer off very poorly when you watch them again. They tend to be very choppy times. So bear with me. About a minute, 2 minutes through this replay. Although I can't complain about other guys doing shoutcasts, you know. Can't really blame the guys at GR for kicking me out. And can't really blame anybody who wants to follow me up on the shoutcast. After all, I made those guys, so you really can't complain. Schwutzwagen Type 166 out from the Wehrmacht base. MG jumps into that building, though, dead center. Going to be laying down some fire into those poor engineers that are running around trying to get behind the church. I could go into the God references and the Jesus and the Jesus's references, but I'll withhold. This is the second time we're watching this game, on the second time of this map. Geschützwagen in the middle, just north of the center of AP. Going to lay down some fire, going to push around those engineers while the MG gets into the building. MG going to lay down some fire and the engineers get out of there. MG coming out from Tox, he's going to jump into the church, do some praying. Genuflect, genuflect, hoorah. The American MG has better accuracy than the MG42 out by ECRecon. And if you throw the dice, with the American MG versus the Wehrmacht MG just north of the center VP. You know what? It's pretty much a dice roll depending on who wins that one. American has more accuracy. The American MG has more accuracy. The Wehrmacht MG has a better suppression rate. So, give or take, who wins? I don't know. That can be watched, but up top, if you want to move your screen up top, you have the two engineers harassing and being harassed by the Geschützwagen. Volkswad coming out from our recon, though. I almost said his name, but I did not refrain from it. Mortar coming out from Tox, though. Recon doing a nice job here, securing the part of the map that he needs. On the far southern point, don't go to it, though, but he's got engineers and piles facing out. But let's go back to the middle there, and both MGs are down to one man. They're having a little duel here. Tox, the first to blink there, and jumps out of there. He's got the mortar to back him up. The mortar takes a shot at that MG, but that Recon's MG is going to get out of there. Here come the Volks. Geschützwagen going to harass that mortar there. Just outside of Dog 1. And if you didn't learn from the last cast, Dog 1 is that upper northern bridge, and Dog 2 will be down south on the bridge. That will be on the Allied side. The Geschützwagen was going to give chase there, but it decided not to, meeting the fire from the machine gun emplacement. Tox coming out with the engineer is going to be rolling around behind the hedge there. If you notice in Dog 1, most of the road is red cover, but just if you cling to those fence lines, you can cling to that green cover, get a bit of a lick from it. Two-man, heavy MG coming out from Tox, going to lay down some fire just on Dog 1. Scare off the Volks. Tox coming out with a sniper, so if you go to the tactical map and take a look at all the units, he has the full toolbox. First time we've seen this through the whole tournament. Geschützwagen up north, we're going to give some fire to those engineers. Sniper out from Tox. Very hard to follow here, I know, because Everdose is watching, but that's okay. I do a good job of covering the whole map. Let's do a time sync while we're waiting here. 5 minutes and 35 seconds, 36, 37, 7, 38, 39, 40. Like I said, this replay's a bit choppy. Something's wrong in the code. MG laying down some fire on Dog 1. Gonna have to get out of there, though. Flanked by the Volksgrenadiers. But I add that something about cover here. Very interesting. Green cover is directional. And yellow cover is not. So if you hide in the bushes, you get yellow cover from 360 degrees all around. But green cover's only from the point the green cover covers you. If that makes any sense at all. That MG laying down some fire there at Dog 1, going to be bringing down the fire on the Volks. MG's got to get out of there due to the sniper fire. Recon's, or Tox's sniper, seems to be down at the moment, or down south. Pretty much taking a smoke break. I gotta take a drink. I forgot the last one in our little time sink. Drinking the king of beers here called Budweiser. It's American beer. I hope you guys all are lucky enough to taste it once in a while. Double MG's out from Tox. He's got the engineers going down south. Recon pretty much controlling the center of the map. Gonna be doing a nice job. While Tox is sniper creeps in from the south. Going to be doing some creeping, hopefully jump into that graveyard and lay down some fire. Might do some poaching out there. Poaching is illegal in both countries, I believe. I don't do it myself, unless I'm shooting at men. A little bit of a lull in the action, almost halfway through here. Be surprised to see who wins this. Tox really putting a back, getting on his back heel by building the WSC. That means he's going to have to rely on Rangers or Airborne to make out his infantry support. And everyone needs infantry support. Don't give me that you don't need infantry or riflemen. Because if you don't have riflemen, then you need Rangers or Airborne. And I'm telling you, you need one or the other. You can't just come out with a WSC and not have some sort of infantry. He's capping with a mortar outside of his base. I mean, come on. You know what, I don't dog Tox about anything, and I'm not dogging him now. But I'm telling you, you don't want to be camping around the map with support teams, if you know what I mean. Tier 3 up, Sturm Armory completed up from Recon. So Recon comes out with a Puma here. I believe Tox could be in some serious trouble. We go to the tactical map. Decent sniper duel coming up front. Just northwest of the center VP off the road of Dog 1, to the east of Dog 1 with the MG there. We've got two snipers facing off there. They're kind of lying in wait behind each fence. Could be the worth to watch there. Here comes the Schutzwagen, going to reveal that sniper. Toxic sniper gets out of there. I wonder if Recon sniper is going to take a shot. No, it doesn't. It decides to get out of there and take some pot shots at the second MG just north of Dog 1. Kashut's wagon going to get out of there, and Tox's sniper is revealed. Big time move. We could have seen something special there. Down south, though, Tox loses a engineer squad because of those Volks, but the Volks take a mine right into the face. Something I always like to do to the women back in my old days. I won't go into detail, just to spare y'all. Let's do a time sink while we're waiting and take a swig of that brew. I'm at 9 minutes and 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. About halfway through, Tox really discouraged. Recon saying, I don't know. Tox's main problem here was he went WSC. I'm telling you guys, oh my goodness, I'm telling you. Due to the patches and the changes of this game, you cannot start off 1v1s with the WSC. Just not going to work. The riflemen have the highest capping power of every unit in the game, other than maybe that PE vehicle. What? God dang it. I always talk about it. Anyways, the PE little scooter that caps right off the bat, early game. Anyways, going WSC as American is always a risk. It never works out. And if you have to rely on airborne arrangers for your main force, it's never going to work. Never. You can debate me all you want on that, but I'm going to tell you, if you roll the dice, and two-thirds of the time you're going to lose if you go WSC right off the bat. He's better off, if Tox really wanted WSC that bad, he was better off going with a barracks than WSC. You got to have a barracks there somewhere. Puma moving into Dog 1, going to lay down some fire on the heavy MG. The Puma took some devastating damage from the MG that unleashed that armor-piercing shell rounds onto it. Puma going to have the light of the day here, and I think Tox is in a lot of trouble. This replay could end rather quickly. Double snipers down from Tox down south. Tox pretty much, he went tier 4, but it seems that he's a bit paralyzed at the moment. I don't think he really knows what to do. He went WC, which is a venture we don't really see him go, and I think his brain is stumping him at the moment. Recon taking advantage of this, though, and he's going to be moving out, capping the map. He's got Volks heading down south, just south of the center VP. Going to be hunting down a sniper as well as the MG. Going to flank around here, but they hit a mine. An Os would have pretty much finished off this whole game. Puma, though, not a bad choice. We've got a tank dupe over by Tox. It starts building something. Down south, though, the Volk's going to be charging in. The MGs and snipers there, just from Recon. If we go down south, that might be the most interesting part of this game. Stug 4, or 4 completed from Recon. Recon pretty much owning the day here. I pretty much blame it on Tox going with the WC. I don't understand that. The only reason I could understand him going with the WSC is to have that extra capping power with engineers, but still, this map is not big enough and not suited for that type of play. Stug coming up just out of Dog 2 from Recon there. That Stug's going to pretty much own everything. We do have an M10 out from Tox. M10 versus Stug. Very nice. Tox bringing out the LOL. Tox very confused with this game. I think he's a bit frustrated. I all bring it down to his, you know, you can't build a house on sand or on the beach where the sand's just going to leave. You know, when he built his house on a WSC, and this, unfortunately, a WSC is sand. You really can't rely on a tank destroyer. Very curious to see what Tox did, what doctrine he went. I don't know. I've been watching from Recon's point of view. That M10 is going to be chasing out the Puma and eventually destroying it. Plus 9 XP released. Full retreat from the Wehrmacht in the center. Stug coming up to intervene. Sniper in the middle there, hiding in wait just by the well in the center. West side of the center VP. Puma coming out to battle that deadly M10, but the M10's going to give chase. Probably going to chase that Puma. Puma really doesn't stand a chance. Volks put out the MP40 PP guns, and they don't do any damage to the M10. M10 going to give some more harassment to the Wehrmacht base. Engineers taking pot shots from the sniper in the center of the map. Watch what you will, it doesn't seem like too much is very interesting in this game. But let's go back to the base and see the recon Stug and Puma destroy the M10. The upgunned Puma does nice damage there. It's better off facing the rear armor than the front, as every weapon is, but the Puma does double damage on the rear armor of tanks than the front.
Way to go, engineers. We hold the point.
Does very nice damage there. M10's got to get out of there. Going to travel the road down the center of the map and probably head back and get some repairs from those engineers. Volks and Stormtroopers coming out from recon. Stormtroopers decking up and gearing up with that Shrek. Nice damage being inflicted on both sides of the border here. MG forced to get out of the church and forced to retreat while the Volks are forced to retreat to the MG. Engineer is going to lay down some fire, planting a mine, but as we all know, that if you build or plant mines with engineers or pioneers, or for that matter, Volks or Grenadiers, if you make sandbags or you're taking fire from making sandbags or barbed wire, you take double or even triple damage at times, so make sure you don't build things undercover, or under fire, I mean. Two M10s out by Tox. Tox trying to bring it back here. Here comes the Stug, going to get a big surprise with the two M10s there, just outside of Dog 1. Stug's really not going to hold up to two M10s. The M10s jump on it. The Stug's immobilized. It can't turn once immobilized. It can only fire front. Tox really taking a lot of damage. He might lose that single M10. With the Shrek there to support. There goes one M10. Puma and Shrek here. That second M10 could go down. Oh my goodness. Destroyed engine there in the center of the Stug. We're just watching north of the center VP. Here come the engineers to give fight to the pioneers. There goes the Stug. Shrek shot on the... along with the Puma shot under the M10. The M10's got to get out of there. There it goes. Races across the cornfield. MG laying down some fire on the flanking of the infantry from Tox. Tox's infantry's got to go. Double Shreked up on the Stormtroopers. Here comes the armored car, Puma. Going to be giving chase to that M10. The M10's now running. Funny to see a tank run from a Puma and Double Shrek squad. M10's pretty much dead in the water. It gives a couple shots off, but it's not going to really hold up. And there it goes. Main gun destroyed. Engine destroyed. Shrek's miss. Puma going to be there to finish it off, though.
We are losing a victory point.
Time scene coming on. About 16 minutes and 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50. Very dull game compared to the first one. I blame it all on Tox going with the WSC. Still, I can't pinpoint the doctrine chosen from Tox. I would bet it's a tank doctrine, hopefully bringing out the Calliopes of some sort.
Munitions point under attack. We have territory cut off.
Recon pretty much commanding it all. And I'm not trying to take anything from Recon here by saying that Tox win the WC, because the WC can win at times. But I'm telling you, the Recon played a very nice game with the full toolbox, MG, Volks Grenadiers, Sniper, and... Geschützwagen. Pretty much commanded the center of the map most of the time. Tox in a lot of trouble here. Be interesting to see who... oh, my goodness. Be interesting to see what factions are chosen for the third game and final game, because it looks like Recon is going to win this game. It's funny that Recon says that Wehrmacht is easier to play. You know what? If you're playing Wehrmacht at the end of the game, when you're winning, Wehrmacht is easy to say that they're easy to play. You know, they're very advantageous when they're winning. But when Wehrmacht is on their back heel and you get the ball rolling and you roll that giant boulder down the hill onto them, they pretty much don't hold up very well. Here come the Shreks, going to lay some fire under that M10. They're right outside of Dog 1, and there goes the M10. Sniper also goes down. Oh my goodness, they must have been able to pick off that sniper from Tox. Tox really taking a beating here. He pretty much bent over and took a big swift kick to the behind. I'd rather get hit by a semi coming down the street while walking to my car than play this game as Tox did here. He's in a lot of trouble. Tox goes GG, and that could end it here. That pretty much will, as the replay comes down, 472 to 130 in favor of Recon. Recon playing a nice game here is Wehrmacht. Wehrmacht, not easier to play, but if things go your way early on and your opponent, as American, builds a WC, then you know what, the Wehrmacht is going to have that advantage. Nice bundled grenade coming off from the Shreked up Blitz squad. They're going to be taking out that MG. And that's the game. We're going to end the game here. About 19 minutes. Very short game. Very surprised to see that. You know what? Tox went with the WC, not taking anything from Recon. Devastating for him to do that. You need Rifleman. I think this replay shows pretty much that you need the Rifleman to come out and stomp the Wehrmacht. Tox was in trouble there. He went to WSC to a tank depot. If we, more importantly, let's look to the winner here. Recon, really going with that Tier 1. He went with the full toolbox, commanded the center, and pretty much owned up the south when he needed to. He came out with a sniper there and was pretty much poaching the middle there. And the sniper, a Wehrmacht sniper, pretty much will command the field against the WSC, and that's what we saw today. You know what? You can say to me, Hey, Doug, we brought out an American sniper. American sniper can handle a Wehrmacht sniper. That could be true, but you're relying on a counter snipe, which really doesn't work well unless you have some riflemen there to support you. You need the riflemen. I can't stress that enough. It's frustrating. Anyways, join me for game 3. We're going to be coming out with a specialty game 3. Averdose has been filming these. We're going to be on the same map, which should be interesting to see who chooses what. If I was Recon, I would definitely go Wehrmacht and hope that Tox makes that decision to go in WC again, makes that faulty decision. But anyways, guys, we're 19 minutes, 17 seconds through. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Feedback is always appreciated. Thanks to Everdose for filming this. And as always, easy company. Game on.